join me in welcoming them to the stage.
The Corelli Sonata was written during the Baroque era when the trumpet didn't have any vowels at all. And we could only play the harmonic overtone series, so all the open notes now on the trumpet. And in order to write a melody for that instrument, it always had to be very high, because that's where the partials get closer and closer together the higher you go. And you can get notes that are closer together as opposed to down lower, and it's more like just like an arpeggio, which wouldn't make for a very interesting solo piece. And then in the 1950s, middle of 20th century, there was this sort of rebirth of this Baroque music, resurgence of the music of Bach and all the different Italian allies, Corelli, Torelli, Vivaldi, and the trumpet players were like, well, this stuff is really high, so how are we going to play this on our modern instruments? And the piccolo trumpet was born. So this is half the length of a B. This is a B-flat trumpet, which is what most people have. It does not magically make playing higher on the trumpet easier. More's the pity. What it does is, because it's an octave higher, it displaces where those gaps in our harmonic series are. So it basically halves it. So I have more room in the different harmonics. I'm getting a little too technical here. It's easier to play in tune. It's easier to hit the right note, but you still have to be able to play high on a big trumpet to be able to play this little thing. So I don't know whether I really love playing piccolo trumpet because of the repertoire that you play it for, or I really like the repertoire from the Baroque era because I love playing piccolo trumpet, but I guess both are true. This Corelli Sonata is in 5 movements. A lot of times they will take these pieces and say they're in 3 movements now between publishers and editors. We'll kind of attach the slow beginning to the first, maybe just call it one big movement. But I really think that it's like 5 kind of little vignettes to the sonata. So there are 5 short movements. This is the Corelli Sonata for trumpet, and it would have originally been with a couple of violins, harpsichord, and some kind of continuo instrument, maybe a bassoon or something. But it's a great pleasure, as I said, to have Danielle Gambone on the piano tonight. trumpet, we think of the Haydn, the Hummel, and there's also the Neruda. The Haydn and the Hummel would have been written for a keyed trumpet, kind of almost like saxophone keys. They were experimenting with different ways to get the trumpet to play different notes, unlike the Baroque trumpet that I was just talking about earlier. The Neruda concerto was actually written for a corno di caccia, which is like a small, little, tiny French horn. By all accounts, it sounded kind of trumpety and would have been played by a trumpet player some of the times. Trumpet players play them nowadays. I don't have one. So a lot of people play this on E-flat trumpet. And this piece is very personal to me because I've always loved it. Of the Haydn, the Hummel, and the Neruda, this is definitely my favorite piece. I've used it in a lot of different circumstances. I used it when I was in high school for my audition to get into my undergrad. I used it when I was my undergrad to get into my master's program. And after playing professionally for 10 years, I played it for my DMA audition as well. Not to be a one-hit wonder, but it's just, I really like how it shows what the trumpet can do. I like how it's in a very clear form, as are the Haydn and the Hummel, but there's these nice blocks of playing in the Neruda, and it has a beautiful second movement that I really, really love. So here is the Neruda Concerto in E-flat.
Thank you. Thank you.
three of the pieces on this half of the program were written within the last 5 years, maybe even within the last 4 years. A lot of music was written during the pandemic, actually, because everyone was stuck inside and didn't have a whole lot to do. So, and one of the things I did was to search around for some new music to play. Brandon Dix is a trumpet player who wrote this next piece, Coming Home. I think actually, as well, all three of the pieces on the second half have something in common, that they're all a little melancholy, which I don't consider myself a melancholy person, but I am a very nostalgic person. And he writes about coming home. I think I put the whole quote in the program notes. It's going back to a place that you're very, very familiar with, but it's a little bit different because things have changed, the buildings are different, and that sort of thing. One of the reasons why I wanted to put this piece on my program, I had a sort of coming home moment at the beginning of the summer. I found out that a mentor of mine, someone I looked up to a lot in high school, Lance Bechara, passed away, and I didn't even know he was sick. And he was the conductor of the community band that I grew up playing in. From the second year that I could play the trumpet, I played in the community band and sat there on fourth trumpet playing about 30% of the notes that were going by in front of me. And he was just so encouraging, and he was also like the music teacher of the high school and the shop teacher of the high school. He had his own woodworking company, he built his own house, and he was just like one of those people that does everything and is always happy and never stressed out. And that was really, that always had a big impact on me, not only all the music stuff, but he was a trumpet player too, he played in like a little brass quintet in our hometown. But he was just always so like chill, like it's all right. Don't worry about it. Anyway, so I went back home for his memorial service. It was not a funeral. It was a celebration of his life at the art center in my town, which I can say now is Brockville, Ontario. If I haven't, you probably saw it in my bio that I'm Canadian. I don't know if I've said anything to give that away. I usually do at some point. So I drove back home to Brockville, Ontario, which is, if you know where Syracuse, New York is, if you went 2 hours directly north from Syracuse, went over the Thousand Islands Bridge to the other side of the St. Lawrence River, and then went 15 minutes further east. That's where I grew up, Thousand Islands. And when I was back there, I realized what a beautiful town it is. If you've never been to the Thousand Islands region on either side of the border, it's a really beautiful area of North America. And I was really lucky to grow up there. And when I was back, I was thinking, I couldn't do what I do in Brockville, Ontario. It's too small a place. It's not attached to a big city. Montreal is 2 hours away, Ottawa's an hour north, Toronto's 3.5 hours to the west. But a lot of my friends that I went to high school with stayed there. We went out for dinner and stuff, and I was thinking, you know, you kind of picture like when your life goes in different paths, what would the other path have done? I'm very happy with my path. I never expected to end up in Ohio, I'll tell you that much, but I fell in love with someone from Mentor, Ohio, and we did long distance from, I told you I like to talk, we did long distance from Toronto to Cleveland for 4 years before I moved down here, and the rest is history, I guess. But anyways, so coming home, I would like to dedicate to Mr. Lance Bechara, who was a fantastic man, a great musician, and just a real pillar of that. Here's Brandon Dix's Coming Home. Oh, I forgot our little tour of the trumpet world here. I'm now on a C trumpet. This is what we use mostly in symphony orchestra in North America. There's also a lot of French solo repertoire written for the C trumpet. We are actually getting bigger. That was not intentional, but that's the way it's working out. So C trumpet, I like to joke that I make the most of my money on my C trumpet, I think, because I do a lot of symphony orchestra work. So, and Brandon Dix wrote this for C trumpet. So here's Coming Home. Thank you. Fiona hit the east coast of Canada really hard. It was actually has trumpet and electronics. So this is a bit of a new escapade for me, and hopefully it all works. Here is singing from James David's Sketches in Red Clay. Nishimura. I don't know Miss Nishimura personally, but I do know who the person, the trumpet version of this piece was dedicated to, Dylan Maddox. He's a DMA student at Arizona State in conducting. And he's a really good trumpet player. He's actually from Prince Edward Island, which I was talking about earlier. And he and, so Dylan and Kate have a podcast together called The Band Room. And she originally wrote this piece, Golden Hour, for French horn. But she did a trumpet version for Dylan. And Dylan posted a picture maybe like 2 years ago, a year and a half ago, on Facebook of this new piece for trumpet. And I was like, what is that? She has the beginning marked for flugelhorn and then switched to trumpet. But I was listening to the horn version over and over and over again, so I emailed her and said, what do you think about this being played all the way through on flugelhorn? Because I've got the French horn in my ear. She was like, yeah, awesome, do it. So I have permission from the composer to do what I'm about to do. This is a lovely piece of music. One of the things, she writes a lot of band music, and she's very much influenced by the environment and natural world. She wrote this piece that Kate started coming to her on a drive from New York City to Toronto, a drive that I've done several times myself. I've done some long drives. All of us have been on a road trip at some point driving across the country, and that's kind of what this piece evokes. I'm also a cyclist, which you may have seen my bio, and I was out for a ride today. I did about 25 miles earlier today, and I was just thinking about all the wonderful places I've ridden my bike. I've taken it to France, to Switzerland, to California, to British Columbia, done races in Central Park in New York City and stuff, and all those things were coming to mind as I was thinking about this piece. It's written about that golden hour right before sunset. But it reminds me of really any time of day, especially in fall right now, just how beautiful the countryside can be. So this is